Eto na naman po tayo, isa na naman episode ng Makina Moto Features. Welcome! Noong kailan lang nilabas ng Yamaha Motor Philippines ang Yamaha Mio Gravis. Gravy! Minsan, kung isipin mo, madali rin isang tabi ang isa na namang motor na pangalan ay Mio. Matagal na rin kasi ang Mio series. It's easy to take it for granted kasi nga staple na siya. And the old ones, in our minds, we can all agree, bestseller siya for a good reason. They work. And year in and year out, they have pushed technology in the sub 150cc automatic sector. Habang tumatagal, bibiro din para sa Yamaha na labanin ang mga nauna nila. Paano mo nga naman papalitan ng subok na at naaasahan? Paano mo papalitan ng teknolohiya na parang sagad na sa segment na to na hindi ganun kalaki ang talon sa presyo? Mio Gravis, pasok! Mio Gravis, sa unang paningin para siyang Mio Soul pero mas bilugin. Sa design, dito lumihis ang Yamaha Gravis sa mga agresibong mga kanto at linya ng mga dating Mio. Mas bilugin siya ngayon. Mga specs, 4-stroke air-cooled single overhead cam, single cylinder 125cc blue core engine 9.3 hp at 8000 rpm na may torque na 9.5 Nm at 5500 rpm. Electric start siya at kickstart 0.84 liters lang ng langis, change oil ka na. It is fuel injected, it is a V-belt automatic, meron siyang single disc brake sa harap, drum naman sa likod. Fuel tank is at 4.2 liters. Timbang niya ay nasa 100 kgs, so siya ang pinakamabigat na kapatid ng sub 150cc na Mio, with a difference of about 8 to 2 kgs depending on which Mio you are comparing it to. Is it a bad thing considering kung asan tangke niya ngayon? Not necessarily. Mas efficient ang motor with a lower center of gravity when it comes to handling. And with smaller wheels, di ganun kapurasado ang makina. In the city, no questions asked. Yung pagka-practical sa paggamit ng maliit at maliksi na sasakyan sa masikip nating syudad ay litaw na litaw. Here we go, ladies and gentlemen. It is the all-new Yamaha Mio Gravis. Gravy! So basically, this bike is going in between the Mio i125 and, dare I say, the Aerox. So the Gravis is heavier than the Mio i125, but not by much. The difference of about 7 kilos or something like that. It's definitely bigger and heftier than the Mio i125, but it is smaller than the Aerox. And step through din siya dito, unlike the Aerox. May gulay board tayo. Now, first thing that I would want to point out here is the finish. Pag matte kasi yung finish, when you're looking at it at certain angles, epekto kasi ng ibang magagandang klaseng mga matte na finish. Makikita mo yung mga shade na hindi mo mahuhuli pag glossy yung finish mo. As the sun hits it, as it goes under the clouds, as you can see, it's getting brighter right now. The sun speaking from the clouds. Yung shadow niya mas pronounced sa matte because matte colors absorb light. It doesn't bounce light. So yung mga gustong cues ng Yamaha, makikita mo in different angles kaya siya nakakatuwa. Like for example, here you'll see a shadow over here. You'll see the shadow over here also. May highlight naman dito. Usually pag gloss yan, mas pino yung talbog na ilaw sa mga kanto. Ito, nakikita mo yung mga ibang graduation sa mga shades niya. So okay yun. Let's look at it on this side. See, iba na naman yung kinalabasan ng mga shadows. In direct light, harap-harapan, you'll see the shadow over here also. So you'll see lines over here. So misnomer yung sinasabi nilang pag matte, parang walang linya yung motor. Depende rin sa design niya sa mga ukit-ukit. So dito, makikita mo yung linya dito, 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 dito. Maganda at malambot ang bagsak ng ilaw sa motor. I don't know if you can see it that way. Maganda rin kasi sa matte finish, hindi siya dumihin kung medyo siya dusty or not. It just looks clean stuff. I'm also digging the side facade here. While some are steep, this is a bit slanted like that. Looks really nice. Para siyang barrel chested, very macho looking.
gosh.
Is this doble placa ready? No, it's not. And I hope that thing doesn't push through ever. Blue core engine, of course, it's got SMG2, which basically silently starts your engine. Di mo na kailangan ng starting motor. With the SMG, that also contributes to overall lightness. One of the striking things that I like in the whole proportion of this are the thicker tires and smaller wheels. Kasi for me, scoot na talaga yung dating niya. Let's take a closer look. Start with the rear first. What we have here is 110 over 90 over 12. That's the rear. Kapalo, ganda. Front is slightly smaller at 100, 90, and 12. Those are the tires. Sa paggamit ko naman, kapit naman siya. So they sported some IRC tires over here. And the IRC is a pretty good brand. Masasalat mo naman yung klaseng lagkit ng mga gulong eh, diba? Saan nagbago. We got some disc brakes at the front and at the rear. Got some good old drum brakes. And I'm hoping sa mga ibang versions ng Gravis, karon din silang disc brakes sa likod. There, LED lights, incandescent signal lights. For the rear, as I suspect, we got some regular lights at the rear. For the gauge, one button lang pag-iisipan natin. We got the battery voltage going on there. Your odometer, we're at 156 right now. Trip 1, and that's it. And if we turn this thing on, other indicators on the top would be your signal, engine check, and headlights. This one, I see no provisions. Maybe in another version of the Gravis, meron siya. That's pretty much what that is. Usina, what does it sound like? It's your regular meep meep. I don't like reading manuals because I like surprising myself with, you know, these little things with the bike and trying to figure things out on my own. So, nung unang nakita ko to, like, ano to? So, kinakalkal ko pa siya. Diba? Try ko buksan. Kaya to, provision ba to? Nalagyan na ng maliit na baso? Or what? I didn't know. And then, when I opened the seat and looked at the whole space over here, hinahanap ko, asan yung gas tank? And then I go back here, and I'm like, aha! So, I pressed fuel. Boom! There you go. Huh? Isn't that awesome? One more time. Boom! We'll try to do it in slow motion this time. So, dyan yung daan ng gas. But that's not where the gas tank is. The gas tank is actually located all the way here sa ilalim. So, this is solid. It's not moving about or anything like that. It's well hinged. This is heavy duty stuff they put there. Bakal naman to. So, that's good. Let's close that. So you're gonna be gassing up over there. Gasoline will go all the way down here. Hindi dito yung gas tank. It's actually down here under the floorboard. And you might be asking,
Zach, di ba delikado yan? Paano pag nalubak ka? Tandyan yung gasolina mo, di ba? Baka sumabog, boom!
Actually, no. Meron siyang reinforcement dito na bakal surrounding the gas tank. So hindi siya basta-basta exposed or delikado. You got some reinforcement here. The tubes going around there at the back on the other side as well. The good thing about putting the gas tank right over here as opposed to yung mga ibang Mio na nandyan, the center of gravity is much, much lower. You have a lot of weight at the bottom of the bike and that is really good for handling as opposed to nasa taas yung bigat ng motor, di ba? Pag nasa ilalim lahat yan, mas okay. Kaya nga, di ba, pag nagbe-banking-banking sina Rossi, di ba, they try to go low and they put their body to the side. So, hindi nasa taas yung weight ng motor. It's gonna be on this side. In this case, gasolina nandito tayo. Which is why handling the Mio Gravis really, really excels and you'll feel it when you try it. And I was enjoying myself in the twisty with this. Now, as for the step board, it's pretty spacious. I am a size 11. Alam mo naman sinasabi nila sa mga lalaking malalaki ang paa. I got a lot of leg room right here, and when I turn the handlebar, comfortable seating position. This is my normal. It's not hitting my long legs. So you got a lot of space over here, so that's pretty cool. Pretty roomy, automatic.
Yeah, sapitan. I think it would also be cool if they had like some sort of parang lagayan ng barya. You know, little mga anik-anik na pwede natin lagay dyan. That would be nice. But you know, still, this whole part looks clean.
For the seat compartment, press this little button. This thing opens. And we have this much space going on. Look at that. 25 liters. Can it fit a full face helmet? We shall see. Since meron siyang indentation, so malamang pababa. Will that fit? And it fits. No problem. The only thing here is, kung maarte ka sa helmet mo, dahil rekta yung top of the helmet with this one, you can maybe put some little padding there, a little rubber mat, para hindi siya magasgas. But it fits. Just a caveat, depende sa korte ng full face helmet mo. Yung sa akin, the SMK, It fit fine. Hey, I wonder, I'll try my Shoei too. Oh, it's not closing. Let's try it this way. Aha! There! It fit perfectly. So yung Shoei helmet, depende rin sa position. So Shoei helmet with the visor facing this way will fit fine. Let's go back to my SMK helmet. If I need to force the issue or not. Ayun, palambot na mapasok. I didn't need to jam it down or anything or force the issue. Gentle push and it's nice and locked. Good job! Full size helmet, Gravis. Kung may kukustom lang man ako dito and I would change something first, I'll probably put an upholstery that's not as plasticky and as shiny looking, but a bit more on the matte side of things to complement the already matte finish. Not a big fan of shiny seats. So let's see, yeah, it's that type of vinyl, see? What's nice about this, it's pretty much easy to clean, very easy to maintain. It's got a big ass seat. Look at how big this is, I mean, see? Kung malaki ang puwet mo, walang problema dito. In terms of the cushion, okay din yung cushion niya. Sobrang komportable. And over at the side, got a lot of foam here. Very generous for the side of your ass too. Minimal decals here. Nice and embossed. This looks nice and elegant. You got some highlights over here. Glossy decals on top of the mat. Blue core engine, of course. Blue core! Plastics on this one is also okay. Same with this one. Going over to the shoulder. Plastic on this one, I would say, would be on the regular as compared to what you have out here on the front. This is of better quality than this one. Of course, you can't compare. They're in two different parts of the bike, but I'm just saying. I would say this part also is a bit on the regular side. Plastic here is nice. This one is also good. Gauge plastic is also good. Ang iniiwasan mo dito yung pag, syempre, kakaparada sa labas. Yung namumuti na plastic. Looks like hindi naman ito yung ganong klaseng plastic na yun. Nice highlight is our grab bar here is a glossy finish. It's in contrast again with the matte finish. Tumeterno siya dun sa glossy decals natin. Makapit naman yung grips natin dito. Switches are also okay. They didn't scrimp on this one. Iba kasi dito tinitipid eh. This is also good quality rubber there. Side view mirrors, I would say these are on the regular side. If I could change anything, I'd also change these. Levers are on the regular side of things. So I think one of the key things here with the Gravis, it's simplicity, elegance, and function.
Consumo, walwal mode, sa timbang ko na 170 pounds at 6 feet, naka 52.631 kpl tayo. Panalo!
Let's try the brakes. On asphalt, the rear, gently. Gonna be a bit more aggressive now with the rear. You know what I like about the Yamaha scoots? You really have to grip it before the rear locks. It's not like an easy lock. Now that's a lot of grip that I'm doing there. Let's try the front now. Wow, the front is nice. No locking at all, huh? Great, it's not prone to locking. Okay, there you go. But that's really gripping it really hard. Remember when you're doing these things, as soon as you hear the front skid, let go already and start pumping your hand. Kasi wala nga siyang ABS. At pag tinuloy-tuloy mo yung grip at nag-skid, you're gonna lose your front, you're gonna fall. You're gonna drop. Nice. Again! Okay, nag-e-end doon na. Of course, both now, humps. Good stopping. So Yamaha, I would say, in this segment, yung brakes nila, it's so hard to find any fault. You have to really squeeze for it to skid. For both. Good. Let's go to a flame seat area now. Yeah, but this is really slippery. Can we do some fishtail here? The front, I won't even attempt here. Ayoko sumemp lang.
Sa halagang 85,900, sa opinion ko lang ha, napadpad na naman ang bagong alok ng Yamaha sa tinatawag kong SPP category or sulit, praktikal, at pogi. Madali i-maintain ang Mio Gravis. Tipid sa gasolina, may bagong handling experience, may napakalaking storage space, at madaling i-ride. Kung may ihihiling lang ako ha, kung kaya lang naman nila gawin, ay sana masiksik nila yung makina ng Aerox sa ganyang klaseng kaha. Parang saya nun, di ba? Wala. Tuloy ang pagiging matatag ng tatak Mio ng Yamaha at patuloy na magiging household name ang Mio sa tahanan ng mga motorista sa larangan ng automatic. Maraming salamat sa pagnood. Ito po si Sir Zach na nagsasabing, laging tandaan, ang tinatandaan ay matatandaan. Ciao!
Kahit na ang bahagari, sikretong babahagi, mga ulap bihahawi, nais ko rin mawari sa puso mo mamalagi. Makita ka palagi, lungkot ko ay napapawi, matamis na iyong labi, sa isip ko sumasagi. Hiraya manawari, sana ay ganito palagi, tila yata ay nayari, sa swerte ako'y palubi. Di na nga magpapalugi, pwede ba kitang maari na talunin.
Sakaling ang mundo bukas ay kumuho, basta ang alam mo, ikaw ang mahal ko.
Pakinggan mo sana mga nakatagong mga himig, handog na may pag-ibig, dalang mga ligalig, buwan akong kinikilig, masdan mo umiibig. Sa dagat masigasig, mapayapa kitang iniibig. Malapili ko lang, marami ang nakaabang, mga matang nakapaligid, ayaw palamang malamang. Di ako magtatabang, di ka sana magsawa, hindi ako malalamang. Talunin, sapat ng pahiwatig, wala na ang iyong galit.
Gabi-gabi na lang ikaw ang aking panaginip.
Ngiti hanggang gilagit, sa'yo ay naaakit.
Sabay halik sa hangin, malakas na pagkaihip.
Mga tanong na bakit ako ay nilalait.
Maramdaman mo sana at sumagi sa iyong isip.
Gusto ko mang lumapit, maraming nakasingit.
Puso mo'y nasilip, nabigong paulit-ulit. Bilog ang mundo, huwag mo sanang iikot sa atin. Malay ba natin kung para ba talaga sa atin?
Ikaw ay alanganin, hinga ka lang malalim. Palasyo na mahangin, partida pikit ka lang at
talon.
Kahit gaano kataas ay tatalunin. Mm-hmm.